गुड इवनिंग गाइस।
गुड इवनिंग सर।
गुड इवनिंग यार, सी टुडे वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग विद रेगुलेशंस। दिस विल बी द फर्स्ट चैप्टर इन रेगुलेशंस। ओके, सी अनलाइक नेविगेशन और मेटेरोलॉजी, इन रेगुलेशंस देयर इज नथिंग मच टू अंडरस्टैंड। करेक्ट, इट इज ऑल रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस बेस्ड ऑन व्हिच क्वेश्चन पेपर्स आर डेवलप्ड। Now, where are these question papers developed? There are some question banks like OLERAIR, correct? Some back questions like RK Bali, correct? And I will be giving you before exam at least 500 questions or 600 questions to practice. Okay, so these questions will almost cover 90% of your exam questions. Okay, so rest 10. I cannot promise anything because rules and regulations is very huge. Correct. It is all there on the DGCA websites, Airport Authority of India websites. Correct. So no one can cover all syllabus. I too cannot cover. But 90 marks are guaranteed. Correct. Only from the class. Okay. So if you just follow the class, if you just try to memorize my terminology. Correct. So if I would, by the end of this class, you will understand what is meant by my terminology. Correct. So I'll try to put my sentences, which I speak in a fashion that those sentences are questions in exam. Understood? So I'll keep all classes. Mostly it should be like a general discussion and it should be fun. Okay. So by the time I end this class, or I end every class in regulations, it should already be memorized. Correct. There is nothing to go home and again read again. Correct. So I'll be sharing all slides with you for regulations. Okay. But the only request is don't send these slides out to anyone. Correct. Next. See. In 1994, okay, before 1994, in the world, it was like ki, here there was no rules or regulations while flying aircrafts. Correct? Every country has their own rules. Correct. For example, if a country shape was like this, okay, so it has to go from, let's say this is city name by A. Okay, it has to go to city B. See. This part is formed by another country. Okay. Now, an aircraft taking off from A had to go to B like this. What these guys used to do? These guys used to take down the aircraft. They would say, you are flying on our territory. Now, this aircraft had to go like this. Every time. It would be a huge loss to the airline company. Correct. But essentially, they are not trying to invade the other country or something. But the thing is, like, this country doesn't allow any other airlines to fly over it. So what everyone thought, everything was haphazardous. So they conducted a meeting in Chicago. Correct. So it happened on December 7th, 1944. Okay, that is called as Chicago Convention. Understood? So in this Chicago Convention, they came together, like many countries came together, and they said, yeah, we will form some rules. Correct. I have to have the ability to understand or to follow a common rule. Correct. See, I cannot remember the rules of every country. Correct. I don't know if I am having a technical fault, correct, overflying other country, if I land, they will kill me. It is considered terrorism. Understood? Back then, those days. So they came together in a meeting or kind of thing called as Chicago Convention. And what they did, they took 3 years to form something called as ICAO. Okay. So, in Chicago Convention was held on December 7th, 1944, then they have thought of a few things. One is the privileges of all contracting states and what will be the restrictions. Okay. One is privileges and restrictions. Okay. I know you cannot see. Can you see what I have written on the screen? Is it clear? Okay. Then very good. Okay. One is privileges and restrictions. Correct. Second thing would be here it will give a common rules, correct? International standards and recommended practices for everyone. Correct. It will say how and where to install navigation facilities. Correct. Like, and also some countries were imposing huge these things, prices on this immigration, customs and all. That also was tried to be reduced. Okay. So these nobody will ask you in exams. Okay. These are the main problems which you have to understand why Chicago Convention has decided and formed ICAO. Correct. So they will ask, ICAO was established in the same year when we got our independence, 1947. Okay. What is ICAO full form? International Civil Aviation Organization. Here, what is IGAUD? It will tell here, see, what are your privileges? What are your restrictions? Okay. Me being an Indian, if I have so much money, I cannot buy an aircraft in London and use it for domestic services in London. Correct. So I cannot go to Pakistan and run between two cities. Okay. That will be a crime called cabotage. I'll be committing crime related to the domestic services in other country. Okay. That is a restriction. Even now it is a restriction. Understood? So it will tell what are your privileges, what you can do, and what will be your restrictions. It will tell these are the international standards and recommended practices. I mean, all the chapters we are studying are international standards and recommended practices, except some differences between Indian practices and the international, which we will discuss. Okay. So all these customs and immigrations, how much you have to charge, correct? So it is fixed almost. Yes. Now, for example, they said a rule and India doesn't like it. Okay. So it is told ki India can follow their own rule, but it has to be notified to ICAO within a period of 60 days. How much? 60 days. So within a period of 60 days, India has to give a notice to ICAO that here we are following all the rules of you, but we are changing this one rule. Now, along with the ICAO, I mean, they have decided to form ICAO, correct, in Chicago Convention. There were two more agreements that were signed. Okay. One was International Air Services Transit Agreement. Second was International Air Services Transport Agreement. See, in 1944, India was under whose control?
British control.
So they were not in terms with a few rules because India was already there under British control, correct? So they don't want to give so much freedom. So something like that happened, and we are not a signatory of transport. Okay, so we are not a signatory of International Air Services Air Transport Agreement. Understood? They will ask this question. Here, two other agreements happened. What are they? One is International Air Services Transit Agreement. Other is International Air Services Transport Agreement. Okay, so India is not a signatory of International Air Transport Agreement. Even now it is. For example, for example, ICAO says here, for example, it gave a blunt rule that all the conventional viewers should be replaced with Doppler viewers only all over the world. Correct. India can follow it or it may not follow it. Correct. Who will take the decision? Your options are Ministry of Civil Aviation or DGC, Directorate General of Civil Aviation. Who will take the decision whether to follow ICAO or not? And who can notify the ICAO that we have taken this thing? Is it Ministry or DGCA? This will be a question.
I think, sir, government.
This DGCA.
DGCA.
Okay. So civil aviation is directed by DGCA. Correct. So DGCA takes all the essential decisions. See, Ministry of Civil Aviation, they are more concerned with the ruling. For example, the civil aviation needed so much funds this year. Okay. They may be concerned with that one. Correct. So, but not the essential decisions which have to be taken for flying purposes. Okay. So DGCA will say, yeah, which convention we will follow, which we will not follow. Okay. It will take all the important decisions. Correct. Even these guys come for audit and all. Correct. They will have regular meetings, discussions every time happening in DGCA. Okay. So DGCA is the in charge for all this kind of things. Okay. This is very important. India is not a signatory of International Services Transport Agreement 1944. Okay. The proposal to give effect to an international convention in India is initiated by DGCA only, not by Ministry of Civil Aviation. Okay, next. Now, see, ICAO is formed. Okay, ICAO gives the rules and regulations. Correct. These rules and regulations are in the form of annexes. Correct. See, annexes are total 19 in number. Each annex deals with one topic. For example, Annex 1 deals with licensing. Correct. Now, they will ask, Annex 5 deals with, Annex 7 deals with, Annex 11 deals with. So, you have to know at least the name of annexes. This is what the DGC exam expects you to know. At least the annexes. That if you want to find here, I want to know about the PPL license in India. What exams I have to give? How many hours I have to fly? Where do you go? In which annex? Annex 1, personal license. Correct. In that, there will be somewhere like it will be written, correct, in the document. Now, you have to remember all the names of 19 annexes. Okay. It will take only 5 minutes by the time. In next 5 minutes, you will be like already memorized all these things. Okay. Now, Manthan, why are you coming to class?
To learn regulations.
To learn. Why do you want to learn regulations?
Because sir, as a pilot, we should know the rules and regulations.
Right. So if you want to become a pilot, what is the most important thing? See, how can you tell you are a pilot? Correct. See, if a police catch me on road, correct, I'm driving a car. How can I tell, sir, I am authorized to drive this car? What do you have? License.
License.
Correct. So the first thing, what you are here is for your license. You pass your DGCA exams, you go for flying, you will get your license. Correct?
Yes.
So annex one, nexus one deals with personal licensing. Personal licensing. Am I clear? Is it already there in brain? One first thing is license. Correct. Now, if you want to get your license, there are rules. That means you have to pass DGCA exam. Correct. Next, there are exams. Okay. There are like you have to fly so many hours. In this also, there are rules. Correct. 100 hours solo. All this. Correct. So that means second most important thing for you is your rules. Correct. You have to follow your rules to get your license. Correct. This like license is the primary thing. Correct. For example, I did some fraud and I got my license. You think? Okay. Mine is also license. I can also fly. Correct. But generally, license is given the most importance. How I got the license? the next most important, correct? You have to follow the rules to get your license, correct? So Annex 2 deals with rules of air. What are rules of air? This is the next chapter which we will be studying, correct? The right navigation light should be green, left should be right, red. How to overtake an aircraft? You should never overtake an aircraft. When you cannot overtake an aircraft, correct? So how do you know, like, what to do if you are coming head on with the aircraft, correct? What is the procedure for takeoff? Whether you can turn left or turn right? All these rules, correct, are there. Now, generally, there are another way to remember Annex 2 is rules of air is there are generally two types of rules. Visual flight rules. Flight rules are two types. And instrument flight rules. That means whether you fly visually or you will fly with your instrument. That is also two in number. So second Annex here is rules of air. Am I clear? Here, Manthan, which is the first subject anyone who is preparing for DGCA exams will read?
Easiest, MET.
MET, correct. So, three, MET. Or, see, MET, MET has three letters, correct? So, Annex 3 is Meteorological Services. Now, Annex 4. Here, what do you call 4 in Hindi?
Char.
Char. Correct. It deals with charts. Very simple. Char is charts. Okay. Now, if you take a chart, okay. So in chart, wait, what do you see here in this chart? I want to fly from Hyderabad to, let's say, Mumbai. Now, if I draw a line connecting these two aerodromes, correct, I can fly this route, correct? That means if I draw a line before 4, that is 14, correct? So char is charts. Okay, by the charts, you will remember that you will be using it for flying. Okay, char, charts for flying. Now, on your chart, what will you see? You will see lines connecting aerodromes, correct? So you will put that line in front of 4 and you call it as 14, which is regarding aerodromes, correct? 14, you will find all rules regarding aerodromes. Clear? Ramakant, tell from 1, 2, 3, 4 and 14.
Personal licensing.
Very good.
Second one, rules of air.
Correct.
Third one, meteorology.
Correct. Meteorological and services.
Meteorological services. Fourth one, char, that is charts.
Charts. And 14?
14, routes.
No. What are you connecting in the chart?
Places we are connecting, sir.
What are those? Like, where do you land? You land in Hyderabad, na? In Hyderabad, where do you land? At the aerodrome, na?
Okay, aerodrome connection.
You will exactly be connecting to aerodromes, na? Using lines.
Okay.
So you put that line before 4, so that it will be 14. So aerodromes. Is this clear till now? Correct? Next. Let's see. You know, I was born in 90s. Okay. I'm very happy that I was born in 90s. Now, what is the ticket if you want to go to multiplex nowadays?
150,
175. Okay. When I used to go to movies in my childhood, the ticket was only 5 rupees. Okay. See, all week I used to wait. If my grandmother, I was living with my grandmother. Okay. My grandmother used to give, like, if I go to a shop and come back, she used to give sometimes 50 paise. Okay. There was paise. Like, I mean, we used to buy in paise. Right? If tomato comes, not like today, now Modi is, I don't know what he is doing. I don't know all these things. It has become very costly nowadays, but the ultimate happiness is when you have this 5 rupees, correct? When I have my 5 rupees, I'll definitely go to one place, movie theater. Okay. So that was the dimension of my happiness. Okay. My unit of happiness was 5 rupees. Understood? So that 5 na, when it becomes 5 rupees, like I'm going to move. Okay. I mean, 5 is for dimensional units. It is the dimension of my happiness. Okay. Here you may be thinking, yeah, dimension units though we have studied in navigation. Why are they so important? Here, see, we have seen that what was that in navigation here, Madan? We have seen volumetric convections. What was that flight? Which took fuel in liters instead of
UK. Yes, yes, sir. Yes.
So, like different countries where you following different dimensions, na? One was following liters, one was following UK gallons. Okay, one UK gallon is 4.54 liters here. That means you are taking 400% fuel less than you have to take by mistake if you change the units. Correct. So it was very important back then. So they have laid down rules regarding this also. Am I clear? Okay. 5 is clear. Here, which is the sexiest airline in India? I mean, which, like, because there are only male students now. We will be like this only. Okay. I mean, which one has a very good IATA name, IATA code?
Indigo.
Indigo?
6E.
Correct. Correct. So, Indigo is 6. Okay. And what do they conduct? Indigo, what do they conduct? They operate the aircraft, correct? They do operations. Correct. How to operate an aircraft? They are the best here. See, I have flown multiple airlines in India, but no airline could satisfy me as Indigo. Their operations are time to time, correct? If this time the time take the aircraft takes off and lands at that time, correct? One time I traveled to SpiceJet. Believe me, that was the last time. Okay, so Indigo is 6E, correct? Indigo the IATA code starts with 6, correct? So what does it conduct? It conducts operations, correct? So 6 is operations. Okay. Here, how many of you have attended the class for this flight plan? Manthan, we have not done flight plan, correct? So see, in flight plan, the first box we fill before every flight is 7th box. Okay. For pilots, the filling starts from 7th box. Okay. Till 6th, it is for to be filled by ATC. Clear? Am I clear? So 7th box, what will you fill? Here, your aircraft registration here. Understood? Your aircraft registration. Also remember this for there also, so that you will not two birds at one shot, na? 7th box in flight plan. When you fill your aircraft registration. Correct. So 7 deals with aircraft nationality and registration marks. Now, Manthan, take 5 seconds to memorize everything. You have to tell whatever number I ask, and you have to tell me why you have memorized that. Done. 6.
6 is Indigo 6E.
What does it
do? Operations. They conduct operations.
Correct. 6. Annex 6 is operations.
Operations.
It is 14.
14 is aerodrome, sir. Charts. Charts and charts.
Yeah. 4 is chart.
4 is charts. Yes.
14 is?
And 14 in aerodromes.
Number 2. Annex 2.
Number 2 is rules, sir. Rules of air.
Number 3?
3 is meteorological conditions.
Number 5?
5 is your dimension of your art, 5 rupees.
So 5 is dimension
unit and unit conversion.
Okay. Have you seen this Kung Fu Panda movie? Anyone? Correct. There is a symbol like this, correct? It will be something like this. Okay. So it will look like this, no? Okay. That means like these warriors are too much worthy for it to have that kind of symbol. Understood? Does it look like 8? Does it look like 8? For me, it looks like 8 only here. I'll show you how it looks like it. Which number is it? Eight only, na?
Okay.
So 8 is airworthiness. They're worthy, na, to fly. If an aircraft is worthy or not, it should have that Kung Fu Panda symbol. That is air. So annex 8 is airworthiness. See, you know, me and my friend, okay, we got married at the same time. So every night at 9 a.m. we used to live side by side houses. Okay, so whatever we are doing, we will stop. If I'm eating also, I'll complete my food by 9 p.m. Night 9 p.m. Okay, so we used to go out, have 2 or 3 pecs, and then come back. Okay. 9 p.m. that facility of 2 pecs, na, we used to keep our busy lives a bit light. Right. So that facility is only at 9 p.m. Okay, because all day I have to work, na, all day I have to concentrate, all day I have to see patients. It is very stressful for a doctor. Correct. Right. So 9 is facilitation, like facilities. You remember the name facilities. Like when we read the chapter facilitation, I'll teach you what are all the things included in this sense. Correct? 9 is facility. Here, I want you to make the sound. 10 till. Say, please say.
10 till.
Correct. 10 is till. 10 tel. Telecommunications. Clear? 10 is telecommunications. Okay. So till now, see, I will also say without seeing. Okay, first I'll say. Then you, one of you can say. One, that first thing I came here is for licensing. First, annex one is licensing. Two, I have to follow rules. There are two rules, IFR and VFR. So annex two is rules of air. Annex three, next, if I'm following rules and I want my license, next thing is metrology. Met has three letters. So meteorological services, charts. That's how I know aerodromes is 14. Correct, the lines I add. Correct, next. Number five. Five is dimensional units. That was the measure of my happiness. Six C operations. I will never forget it. Okay. Seven, two birds in one shot. That one is like in flight plan. I'll write in the box 7 my registration number. So here also registration marks. Okay, and identification of this aircraft. So. Next, eight airworthiness, because like, see, the Kung Fu Panda, it has to be stamped on the aircraft to be airworthy, correct? 9, here, facility I got, here, facilitation. 10, telecommunications, clear? So any one of you can repeat. Here, why am I stressing this so much? Because these are memory points, huh? And they definitely will come in exam. Okay, today we will cover at least 3 questions in exam. Go ahead, someone you tell, someone can tell. I'll be here and listening to you. Who wants to tell?
Sir, first is personal licensing.
Okay.
Second is rules of air, because IFR and VFR. So second is rules of air. So third one is meteorological conditions, right? Fourth means char.
Meteorological services.
Huh? Services, okay. Four means char. That's why chart.
Correct.
And so we found the 14th one, aerodrome.
Okay.
Fifth is dimension of your happiness, means measure dimension units.
Okay.
Sixth is 6E indigo, which conducts operations.
Correct.
Yes. Seventh is the flight plant box number 7, aircraft nationality and marks.
Mm-hmm.
Eighth is from Kung Fu Panda movie. Eighth number. So airworthiness.
Correct.
Ninth is facilitation, because the facility of that 2-pack with friends at 9 a.m. 9 p.m. Yes, and 10 is Tentel, telecommunication.
Very good. Okay, Ramakant, next you will be telling all 20 together. Okay, so listen carefully now. Here, see, Manthan, here, do you have a drone with you?
Drone
camera nowadays.
Yes, yes. I flew the drone camera.
Okay, now see, like if you want to take an aerial shot of a national highway with like a bit traffic, here, won't it be nice? Correct. So if you see the highway from a very high angle, how will it look? It will look like this, correct? Correct. Very nice. You can stand in between and take. Okay. And there will be traffic also.
Correct.
Like this, cars going. Okay. Understand? So, can I say this looks like which number?
11.
11, correct. So, 11 deals with the traffic. Okay. So, 11 deals with traffic. So 11 is air traffic services. Now what is 12? Here, see, imagine you are flying, correct? You are flying in a traffic pattern, okay? If you don't reply for a long time to ATC, or if they cannot see you on radar, what will they first do? They will say, here, one aircraft has become accident. We will go and do accident investigation. No, they will try to find out where are you. Correct. So if an aircraft gets missed from the traffic pattern, they will find out where the aircraft is. Correct. So number 12 deals with search and rescue. Search and rescue. Am I clear? Yes, number 12 deals with search and rescue. Then they will say, yeah, you have landed safely somewhere, but on the road, and you have caused a small damage to the road, for example, a pole, correct? And what, why this has happened? There was a malfunction in the engine, correct? So what is the cause for this malfunction? Like, was it like natural, or was the aircraft not maintained? So all this comes under the investigation part. Correct, accident investigation. So first, 11 is air traffic services, because that you see the road, the traffic, correct, from the top. So 11 is air traffic services. Next is search and rescue immediately. 13 is accident investigation. Okay. Just because I'm a doctor in investigations, I'm used to like IX. Okay, please note down as full accident investigation. Okay. So 14, you know aerodromes.
Correct.
Here, let's take a look. Take a look, everybody, at the screen. Annex 15. Ramakant, you have scored 94 in mid, correct?
Yes, sir.
What is this? What is like A I S? What is the full form? Which is the chapter that I took just 2 days before the exam so that you will just vomit it in the exam and you come back? Meteorological Services of India, correct?
Yes, sir. Same I remember way. The numbers also.
So, same way, AIS is Aeronautical Information Services. Okay. Aeronautical Information Services. See, it is easy. Annex 15 is easy. The easiest. Okay. A15. Aeronautical Information Services. Correct. Here, see, I agree, I have a pretty bad mind. Okay. So I cannot say my own mnemonic to you. Okay. So what I'll do is I will say a mnemonic. Okay. But I cannot help it here. I cannot give you the original mnemonic. No. Okay. You will feel your sir is so stupid. Sir is, oh, next tomorrow you will not come to class. Okay. So see, which is the most, like, for example, you want to fly from Hyderabad to Mumbai. Okay. If you fly on time and the shortest possible route, you will save a lot of fuel and you will protect the environment, correct? Your emissions are less, correct? So which airline does it? Indigo, correct? So Indigo 6 was operations, correct? 16, okay? 16 is environmental protection, okay? So I will not be giving the original mnemonic. From 6 Indigo, you take it as 16 environmental protection. I'll just stop my share and share again. Okay. I think screen, my cable, remove cable, put the cable, share. Okay, so 16 is environmental protection. Here, see. Why am I teaching you guys? See, tell me one advantage of me taking ground classes than working as a doctor. Not the salary. I earn a lot as a doctor. But that was not the primary motto. Okay, so what is the advantage of me taking classes? Thing is, see, I can conduct classes at my own timings. Understand? What is the time now? 7 a.m., 7 p.m. in the night. Okay, because you students are like with me for other subjects. So I took you in. Correct. You are also comfortable. I am also comfortable. Correct. And I can stay with my parents. I can stay with my kid. Okay. I can play with him all day. Correct. Except in the class timings. Okay. You have seen me sometimes. I'll bring my kid into the classes also. Correct. So 17, okay, 17 is like, yeah, 17 hours is how much? 5 p.m., correct? 9 to 5 jobs is this something like I hate so much, yeah? Okay, I'll be always looking at the security guard, okay? Like when 5 p.m. happens, so like the security guard will close this one door and open the other door because the next duty doctors will come from back. We leave from front, understood? They will be taking the rounds. Okay, so I like when it is close to 5 p.m., all eyes on security guard. Okay, so who closes the office if you are doing a 9 to 5 job at 5 p.m.? Security guard only, correct? So 1700 hours or 17, annex 17 is security. Okay. Here, name two things which are most dangerous and you should never have it in your life. Alcohol, cigarettes, correct? So now, if you go to a bar, what is the minimum age?
21.
No.
18.
Okay. So 18 is like, 18 is like the most dangerous thing here. Alcohol enters life at 18. Okay. It will, some people will say no, and they keep on working hard and grow into like very good adults. Some people will get addicted to it and their life ends very soon. Understood? So 18 is the most dangerous thing. So 18 deals with dangerous goods. At 18, you should be in a place ki you will be dealing with these dangerous goods and you should overcome those addictions. Here. Okay, fine. Stay safe. Okay, if I call you, stay safe. Great. That lady will be telling, na? Amitabh Bachchan also will tell sometimes. Great. Stay safe from whom? From COVID-19. Correct. So 19 is safety management. 19 is safety management. Okay. See, I will tell from 11 to 12. 11 to 20. 11 to 19, sorry. 11 to 19. There are only 19. 11, okay, I'm seeing the highway. Air traffic services. 12, I'm lost, search and rescue. Okay, I have crashed, accident investigation. 14, aerodromes. Great. 15, aeronautical information services. 16, my mnemonic no-no. So from operations, Indigo. Okay, they do protect the environment by taking the shortest route and being on time. Correct. Environmental protection. 17, here 5 p.m. Here I am looking at the security guard. Security. Correct. 17, after this, 18. 18, here dangerous goods, alcohol. Please don't touch the alcohol. Okay. 19. COVID-19, hi, bhai. Be safe. Okay. Ramakant, it's your turn now. Take a look. Take a look for 30 seconds and you should tell without saying.
I'll try, sir.
Yeah.
First one, personal licensing.
Okay.
Second one, rules of air.
Okay.
Third one, meteorological.
Okay.
Fourth one, charts.
Okay.
Fifth one, dimension of happiness. So, dimension. Okay. Then sixth one, 6E.
Okay.
So, operations. Seventh one, aircraft registrations and nationality.
Okay.
Flight plan. And eighth one, Kung Fu Panda worthiness.
Okay,
air worthiness. Ninth one, 1 second, sir. 10th one is Tentel, telecommunications. Ninth
nine,
one.
So 9 p.m. what I should do? See, 5 nine, p.m. and 9 p.m. you have to remember. 9 p.m.
9 p.m.
What I should have, I used to have facility.
Drinks, sir. Facilities. Facilities. 11th one is
facilitation. You say
facilitation. Facilitation.
Okay.
11th one is air traffic, road. 12th one is search and research.
Search and rescue.
Search and rescue. 13th one is 1 second, sir. 13th one is accidental investigation.
Okay.
14th one is aerodromes.
Okay.
From there. 15th one is AIS. This one, investigation. No. Aerodrome
Aeronautical information services. Like the meteorological information services, correct?
Aeronautical information services. Then 16th one is environmental protection.
Correct.
17th one is, one second. 17th one. 18th one is danger. 19th one is COVID-19. So safety. 18th is dangerous. 17th is, 1 second, sir.
Mantan.
5 p.m., sir.
5 p.m. Security.
Very good. So you did not see at anything, correct? You did not see. So you were able to memorize everything. Okay. That's all. And revise it here. After 2 days, na, nothing will be there. But if you revise 2 or 3 times, you will never forget. Okay. I read this for my exam. I did not forget. Okay. Here, see, along with Chicago conventions, there are other conventions also. Because, see, it is not like, say, for example, you go to a house, you take it as a rent. Okay. Now I took this house. This is a rental property where I am staying in. We have written an agreement. Okay. Chicago convention is done, which is major. It is taking care of major things. Now, yesterday someone came and hit my car in the parking. Correct? Now, the camera has recorded who is this. Now, will he pay or not? I don't know. Understood? Because I did not make any agreement. Here, if like someone who is related to the owner, if damages something, here who will be paying it? He will be paying completely or it is at my risk, I'm parking. Correct? Because nothing was mentioned in the agreement regarding parking. Understood. So other problems also came up. So again, meetings were held, correct? But not in Chicago. Like, see, Narendra Modi goes to one country to take one meeting, other country to take one meeting, correct? So now there are other conventions, okay? Correct. So here, see, honestly, I never watch news, I never watch sports, okay? I don't know. I know only one guy who is a politician, that is Narendra Modi. So don't think I am against someone or like this, okay? What I know is like not even the tip of iceberg. I don't know anything regarding this politics, regarding the economy. I don't care. Okay. As long as when I switch on the TV, if serial comes in the night, I will see the serial. I will sleep. Okay. That's all. Okay. I don't even watch news. I don't even watch these things. Okay. Of course, I don't watch serials also. I'm just giving an example. See, now, same way, like there were other conventions. Okay, they will ask, here, Tokyo conventions is about. Okay, say Tokyo. Say Tokyo. Say it.
Tokyo.
Okay. If you're flying and someone comes and took your controls, what is it called as?
Hijack,
correct? It is given in the name here. That's why they kept the convention in Tokyo. Took your controls, correct? Took control. Someone took control of your aircraft, took you. So Tokyo convention is mostly about hijack. Understood? So it also mentions, if for example, someone is trying to enter the cockpit, correct? The pilot in command has, if he has reasonable grounds, he can restrain. That means he can tie up or he can hold the passenger like this. Okay. He can take reasonable measures. Okay. And what he has to do, he has to radio. Correct. Delhi Tower, Air India 123. We have a suspect trying to break into the cockpit. We have restrained him with the help of passengers. Okay. We will be. Please give us priority for landing, and also like we will be like needing the someone from the security personnel to come and take over. Okay, who is really authorized in the airport to take over? Correct. These people will be there now. The security while going into the airport and all, they will be checking you. Correct. So they will come over and they will take over, and from there the pilot in command is not responsible. Correct. He will just hand over them to the competent authorities. Okay, the wordings are important here. See, hijack, if it comes, it is Tokyo. Okay, if they say like, here, can an aircraft commander restrain? Yes. Okay, which convention has decided, here, this can be, this aircraft commander can do it? It is Tokyo convention. Understood? And what can he do? Can he beat up the person? Can he kill the person? No. He cannot do anything. He will just deliver that person to competent authorities. Okay. So I was talking about English now. This is the English you have to know. Tokyo, hijack, aircraft commander can impose reasonable measures, including restraint, and I mean on reasonable grounds, and deliver this person to competent authorities. Correct. So if you remember this, you need not remember anything. Okay. So Tokyo has everything: hijack, the aircraft commander, tying up, and delivering the person to the competent authorities. This is Tokyo Convention. Okay. Next. Here, see. For example, I keep on taking ground classes. Okay. Now, slowly, if people think I am doing good, okay, they will encourage me. How will they encourage me? They will join my classes. Correct. Like you guys join for all the subjects. Like they will also join for all subjects. Correct. Now, what happens to me? I will start gaining wealth. Okay. Now, what I do? I do some fraud. Like I will take money in the form of only like cash. Okay. I will not do bank transfers, and I gain huge amount of money. And believe me, what if I have so much money, what I'll do? I'll just buy aircrafts. Correct. So if I buy 10 aircrafts, okay, with this huge money, I'm buying 10 aircrafts. Now, what will they do? Is this property of mine legal? No, correct. So they will seize. What is the spelling of seizure? I'm not sure what is the spelling of seizure. Correct. They will seize my aircrafts. Correct. They will seize my aircraft. So if you see this convention, HAGUE, I remember this as huge. Okay. How do you spell it here? Okay. I don't know yet. Okay. I am concerned about doing my best in the exam. Okay. After this, this piece of information is not useful to me. So this huge unlawful property gets seized. That is my mnemonic. Okay. So it deals with any unlawful seizure of aircraft. For example, olden days, what used to happen? I have given an example. Na? So if you are flying from your country to your country only, you are overflying other country, they landed for technical reasons and they used to seize the property. They used to seize the aircraft. Okay. This has landed here. It is ours. Okay. So it deals with all this kind of shit. Huge convention deals with unlawful seizure of aircraft. Okay. So if Air India aircraft has landed due to technical reasons somewhere else, okay, they cannot seize it. Okay. If they seize, they will have to pay severe penalties. Such offenses will be given severe penalties. You cannot seize an aircraft at any point of time. Understood? No country can seize other country's aircraft at any point of time, unless there is a war going on or something like this. Shit. Okay. But don't expect, like, other countries who are not have signed this convention or something. Like, for example, you go and land in North Korea, you're not coming back. Understand? So not all countries will be following this. Only these countries which have signed ICAO, which are signatories of ICAO. Clear? So huge unlawful seizure of aircraft. Now, Ramakant, tell me Tokyo Convention.
Tokyo Convention is hijack, sir. Hijack of aircraft, and commander can restrain him.
No, I want to tell you like this. Tokyo.
Tokyo, okay. Tokyo is Tokyo hijack.
Correct. Huge getting
unlawful seizure of aircraft. Unlawful huge seizure. Penalties.
It's severe penalties. Okay. Here, see. Here, how many, like, you know, I have a very bad habit. Okay. My wife also says that, like, I do some stupid things. One of them is, if two people fight on the road, okay, I enjoy standing there and watching. I'll wait for that kind of shit. Na? see two aunties fighting out of like just close to your house. Okay, I'll stand in the balcony. Like, I really want to go there. Come on, auntie, come on. Okay, understood. Okay, so like, I will wait for the shit to get real. Okay, now these two people fighting, I want to get physical. Now we'll see who will win. Okay, get physical. Okay, so I'm waiting for shit got real, shit to get real. That is Montreal. That is Montreal Convention. How many of you enjoy here? Tell me honestly. Don't you enjoy? If two people are fighting, don't you stand and see? Yeah? Yeah, no? See, everybody is like that only. But I will agree here. I will agree. I will agree my sins. Okay. Even though I'm going to hell, I'll agree. Okay. So Montreal Convention is about shit getting real. That means on an aircraft, if two people are fighting, what is the punishment? It comes under Montreal. Correct. If you want to break the aircraft, for example, window, if aircraft is mid-flight, you are breaking the window. That means like, I will not say, yeah, break, we will see. I'll not say, but I will enjoy the air hostess and all trying to pull him like, yeah, correct. So that shit got real is Montreal, correct. So if you damage, if any air rage, correct, you see a lot of times, this video is now on YouTube. Correct. People fighting with the captain. I want to go home soon. You have delayed the aircraft. For example, someone hits the captain midair. Okay. Captain collapses. Then who will fly the plane? First officer. See, that kind of shit is shit got real Montreal Convention. Okay. All this which endanger the safety of the aircraft. Air rage. Correct. Damaging navigational facilities. For example, an aircraft is coming to land. Okay. You went to the Delhi VOR and damaged it. Now the aircraft is not able to land. Understand? Like you damaged the ILS of Delhi, correct? For example, you want to create some kind of revolution in people, correct? You want to create more jobs. What you do? Ultimately, you got mad and you went and damaged ILS of Delhi. It is a very foggy day and aircrafts are not able to land. Now they have diverted to Jaipur. Who will pay for all this? You will pay ultimately. So this air rage, except all these things, except hijacking, all other acts except hijacking will come under Montreal. Okay. If you try to hijack, it is Tokyo. Correct. Other than hijacking, if you do something to any navigational facility or in midair, okay, try to damage the aircraft in any other way, it will come under Montreal Convention. Okay. Fine. Ramakant, I am very happy that someone who speaks Telugu is with me. Why? Here. What is this?
I don't know reading, writing, sir. I know only speaking.
Oh.
I forgot it long back, sir.
Okay, fine.
See, I think it's Ra, Ru.
No. Va.
Oh, okay.
Ru. Sa. Varusalo pone. What is it? Varusa means what?
In continuation.
Yeah, in a line.
Correct? In a line.
In a line. So, like, for example, if you want to fly from Delhi to Hyderabad, okay, and that day the aircraft is only half booked, but the thing is like online booking. For example, you want to fly, let's say, SpiceJet, okay, that online booking system is fault. Now, where will you reach? You will reach the aircraft, correct? Now you see the huge line. Everybody wants to get the ticket from that aircraft, correct? Imagine that, okay? So that is standing in line, Varusa, correct? We call that as Varusa, Varusa alone level. Like in Telugu, we call this as Varsa. Varsa. Or you can remember this as during wars. For example, see that when Afghanistan, that shit happened, many people, they were standing in line to get into a plane, correct? Somewhere jumping over, somewhere like to get one ticket, it was like their life and death situation. Correct. So in a war, you have to get yourself a ticket, your luggage should come, you have to take your families, correct? So Warsaw Convention deals with these three things. One is there. Passengers, baggage, and freight. Okay. So they will, they, it has laid down the rules for the passengers. It has laid down the rules for the bags. Correct. And the freight. How much you can charge, how much you cannot charge. Correct. So if they ask in question, the standards of ticketing are laid under which convention? Ticketing comes under, like, you are dealing with the ticket, now passengers, baggage, how much cages will be free, how much can be charged. Okay. So all this will come under what's. Am I clear? Here, how many of you are very good with history? Okay. What was the name of Rome before they constructed Colosseum? So what, you know what is a Colosseum?
Romania.
Huh?
Romania.
No. See, Colosseum is a place where the gladiators fight, correct? You have seen Gladiator movie?
Yes.
Okay. So they used to, like, they started it as a game because Rome was the biggest country back then. So it had many slaves which they captured from other neighboring states. Okay.
Yes.
So what they used to do, they used to make them fight each other, correct? So before these traditions started, Rome's name was R-O-M. That's all. Okay. Now see, once they started fighting, okay, there were dead bodies piling up. Correct. When dead bodies piling up, the population of eagles increased. Correct. Now, what eagles used to come down with their claws, try to hold the dead body and go up. Correct. They also increased their size and all. Correct. That was the day, everyday scenario in Rome. Correct. Those eagles. And these claws, na, they will look like this. Na? When the eagle comes down, the claws will look like this. Correct. So that E is added to the Rome. And now it is called as Rome. Before that, the name was only Rome. Understand? So what was this eagles doing? They were coming and taking the damaged properties. Correct. On Rome, they were damaging things. Of course, they were not only taking the dead bodies, but they were taking the small sheep also. Correct. Small children also sometimes were taken away. Do you believe this? Correct. Eagles can carry like big, like say camels and not camels. Okay. I'm saying sheep and all. Correct. They are very powerful. Correct. They used to cause damage on the third parties. Rome is a third party for eagles. No? Eagles and human beings are first parties. Okay. Now they used to cause damage to the third party. So Rome Convention deals with foreign aircraft damaging third party surface. For example, an aircraft from US came to India, correct? Now, instead of landing on a runway, pilot made an error and landed on a taxiway, and it damaged half of the taxiway, and also nearby there was a navigational equipment we wore that also got damaged. Okay. Now, will this come under Montreal or Rome? See, Montreal is like someone wantingly damaging the navigational facilities, correct? Air rage and all will come under Montreal, correct? Here, some foreign aircraft came and damaged our VWAR. It was by mistake. Okay. So foreign aircrafts, if they cause damage to third parties on the surface, correct? On the surface, correct? And they are liable to pay the compensation, correct? And how much they have to pay? Is it only for the reconstruction of VWAR, or do they have to pay extra? All this is discussed in Rome Convention. Am I clear? So how do you remember? Rome, the eagle come and on the third party surface, they do the damage, correct? So foreign aircraft, because eagles were not there in Rome, correct? They came from somewhere else when they started the dead bodies piling up. They came and caused the damage on the third party surface, correct? So Rome Convention deals with foreign aircraft causing damage on the third party surface. Is this clear? Okay. Now, I'll revise. See, Tokyo, hijack, correct? So, an aircraft commander can, if he thinks on reasonable grounds, he is going to do damage, he can restrain and deliver to competent authorities, correct? Huge unlawful seizure of aircraft comes under huge, and it will have severe penalties, correct? Shit got real, correct? Montreal, okay, air rage, any damage to the navigation facilities, anything you do in the aircraft, try to damage something, except if you try to hijack. If you try to hijack, it comes under TOPL. Correct. Warsaw, people standing in line at Warsaw, correct? So you will send people with their bags, baggages, waiting for the ticket, correct? So it deals with baggages, passengers, their flight, and the ticketing. If you see these words, you know it is Warsaw Convention. Okay. Rome, the eagles coming and damaging the third party. Okay. Here, I'll complete the class in next 15 minutes. Do you want a break?
No, sir.
No. Is it interesting?
Yes, sir. Super interesting.
You know how much boring it was when I was reading for the first time. Here, see. There is something called as Prevention of Terrorism Act. Okay. Now, is this applicable to which aircrafts? A. General aviation. B. General aviation means this small Cessnas, flying schools. If I own my private aircraft, that comes under general aviation. Correct. General and civil aviation. Third option would be civil aviation only. Okay. Option D would be general and military. Option E would be military aircrafts. So which Prevention of Terrorism Act will apply for which aircrafts? Is it only general aviation, general and civil aviation only? Is it for military aircrafts only? Which one?
General and civil aviation.
General and civil, mantan.
Answer, military.
Military, can't they protect themselves?
Yes, sir. They can protect themselves.
Here, this is an act, na? Act says here you cannot hijack. See, you Mantan, you cannot go to, for example, an Air Force base. Here, protect yourself. I am going to hijack. Okay. Even if you do hijack a military aircraft, you are going to jail, na? So, act yes. applies for everyone. It is yes, for general or civil. So, which it is like Prevention of Terrorism Act will apply for all aircrafts, na?
All aircrafts. Yes, sir.
Okay. See, if someone wants to, it applies for all aircrafts. If I want, like for example, to create a question to confuse students, okay? See, you opted for general and civil. Understood? So it applies for all aircrafts. Okay, this is a question sometimes is asked also. Okay, even when I answered also, I answered general and civil. Then I thought, how stupid I am there. Yeah, how many times do you think I am stupid? Sometimes. Sometimes, na? No? I think a lot of times I'm stupid. Here, be careful. Prevention of Terrorism Act will apply for all aircrafts, be it military, be it civil, or be it general aviation. Okay. Next. Prevention of Terrorism Act protects all aircrafts, including military. Correct? See. Mantan, you became a captain. You became a captain with Vistara. Okay, now you are flying from, let's say from India. I'm a biology student. Okay, don't judge my diagrams. If you are flying from India to, let's say, some London. Okay, you have to fly over Pakistan. Okay. Now, while flying over Pakistan, will you follow the rules of India? Will you follow the rules of Pakistan? Or will you follow the rules of London? Or will you follow general rules of ICAO? Which rules do you follow?
Sir, I am Indian pilot, so I know only Indian rules.
Only Indian rules. Yeah, very good. Yeah. See, how will I know Pakistan rules? Okay. Am I giving Pakistan DGCA exams? No, na. So I will know only my rules, na. You should follow only Indian rules. You like if an aircraft is flying. Where is this? If an aircraft is flying over the territory of another state, you should follow rules of the state of registration. Correct. State of registration is like that aircraft is registered to India, correct? Okay. Am I clear? Next. See. Here, at least some diagrams, na? What is this?
South India.
South.
Very good. Very good. Thank you. I mean, you improved. I mean, you made me smile, na? At least I could draw something and you could understand. So this is South India, right? This is Indian Ocean. You know how big is Indian Ocean? It extends to Southern Hemisphere also. Correct? Here, there are some parts of Indian Ocean which comes under India. Okay. Now, you are flying here. Okay. These are called as high seas. Okay. Now, when you're flying over high seas, you will follow which rules? A. Adjacent state rules. B. Your state. I mean, if you are a pilot from, let's say, UK. Okay. Your state rules. Or C, something said by ICAO. Which one do you follow? No
I
answer,
Nathan. I think so. C, sir. Okay. Like if you are in the middle of the ocean, then.
You're correct. Yeah, you're guessing correct.
It makes sense.
Okay. So it is like. The ICAO has laid some rules, correct, when you are flying over high seas. Okay, those rules you have to know and you have to follow them. Okay, you cannot say I will follow my own rules, but you are on high seas, correct? You are not on any other state. You're not, this is not a very, it is not a place where there is a country below you and there is something, a conflict, correct? It is a common rule for everyone. So all aircraft will follow when they are flying overseas a common rules. Till here it is clear. Any doubts?
Yes.
Doubts? Here, there are 6 freedoms of air. If you are an aircraft operator, for example, Manthan went and established an airline, you have 6 freedoms according to ICAO. We will discuss. Your first freedom is, same example, if this is your country, you're going from place A to place B in your country, and this is one more country. Okay, you can fly over this country without stopping. Correct? If you are going to land in your country only. That means right of freedom for aircraft of state A to overfly state B. Let us take this is state A. This city is X city. You're going to Y city. Okay. That is X only. Okay. You're going, this is state B. Correct. You're flying state B. Correct. You're flying over state B. See, you may think here, if I want to go from Delhi to Kolkata, will I go and overfly China and land in Kolkata? No, no. But there are some states na, which for which the other countries will come in. Correct. So they can overfly without landing. Understood? So first right is right of the aircraft from state A to overfly state B without landing. Am I clear? Okay. Your second freedom is, for example, if this aircraft developed technical malfunction. Okay. So for any technical reasons, okay, it can come and land in state B. You cannot say, here you did not take clear permission. Okay, it was an emergency, correct? So if there is an emergency, you can land on any country who have signed ICAO. Am I clear?
So we have to take permission to fly the another state while entering, or we can fly.
You have to definitely file a flight plan. Correct?
Okay. Yes, sir.
They will also acknowledge that your aircraft is entering. For example, there are many aircraft which are overflying. For example, if you take Flight Radar. See, this aircraft is going from Dubai to Shanghai. Correct. It is a Boeing 747. Correct. It is cruising over. See, this the Nagpur ATC also knows that it is coming this way. Correct. This is a route for this aircraft. Correct. So Nagpur ATC will be coordinating here with other flights, giving it levels, coordinating the traffic and all. Am I clear? Idea. So that is the second freedom. Okay, you can land. For example, that aircraft developed some technical malfunction. Sorry, it will not develop, but if that developed, we will be very happy to do whatever they want to save themselves. Okay, next, your third freedom. Okay, from here. They are called as commercial freedoms. First two freedoms are called as technical freedoms. Okay, technically they are not doing anything. They are not gaining money from country B. Correct. So that those first two freedoms are called as technical freedoms of air. Now all other freedoms 3, 4, 5, 6 are called as commercial freedoms because it is related to earning money. Correct. Now. India. Let's say this is Dubai. Okay. See. Let's say this is UK or London. Now see. If I say here, Dog.Pilot and Airlines will carry people. From India, I'll accept money from people and land in Dubai. Okay, if Dubai and India both are have signed ICAO, correct, are signatory countries of ICAO with proper permissions and paperwork, I can take passengers from state A to state B. Okay, so right of aircraft from state A. I mean, I am an Dog.Pilot in aviation. Like Dog.Pilot 10 Airlines now. I have grown. Okay. Can take pilots because it has originated in India, correct? So I am registered to India. So I can take passengers from my country to other country and I can accept cash. Okay. Next. Here, same way, once I have landed here, I can take passengers from Dubai and come and land here. Okay, so from other country to my country, I can do with, of course, proper paperwork and given time slots. Okay, so that is fourth freedom. The right of aircraft from state A, Dog.Pilot and Airlines is from state A, from India, correct? To pick up paying traffic in state B, that is Dubai, and put down in state A, that is in my country, correct? Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, third, fourth. Now, fifth freedom is, here see, I am making a flight from, let's say, India to London. Okay. Now, fifth freedom is, I can pick up traffic from, while I land in Dubai, I'll take some more passengers and I can drop them in London. Okay. Fifth theorem is state A to pick up paying traffic from state B and put down in state C. Am I clear? Okay. Now see.
Wait, sir.
Yes.
Aircraft from state A.
State A. Okay. See, third freedom was my aircraft from state A, an Indian aircraft taking Indian passengers or someone, of course, other nationals also, taking passengers from India to Dubai. That was third. While coming back, I took passengers back. That is fourth. B to A. Indian Airlines taking. Okay. Next is, like, I'm on my way to London, but there is a stop in between. So I can land in Dubai. I can take passengers from Dubai to London. Okay.
Yes.
But here, see, if I say here, see, anyway, for example, take one aircraft. Here, take one aircraft. Say an aircraft from London, registered to London. Okay, I'll take this as red color. See, an aircraft is registered to London. Okay, now have you seen sometimes like Air India, they will land in London and then Delhi, and then they go to Hyderabad. Right? One time I flew Delhi to Hyderabad, all passengers from London, they are all foreigners. Understood? So that only Air India can do. Okay, so this domestic travel from Delhi to Hyderabad, that domestic travel can only be done by domestic airlines. That's why, even though there are some foreign airlines, okay, in India, you would have never seen that they carry domestic passengers from one place to another. Have you seen any time booking like?
No, sir.
Singapore Airlines? No. Correct. So that domestic air services is called as cabotage. It is very strict. Okay, the laws are very strict. Okay, you can never carry passengers from other country to their country. Okay, that domestic services are entirely given to them. There are some states in UK. Okay, there are some states in UK that grant permission to each other. Yeah, you guys come and establish airlines in my country, I'm okay with it. Okay, so until there is something like that, you cannot do cabotage. Cabotage means domestic services, domestic air services. You cannot do in other countries. Am I clear?
Sir,
Suppose
Etihad based in Doha and Emirates based in Dubai, right?
You see, strongly, I come from medical field. Okay. I really don't have a passport even now. Okay. I'm not planning to leave the country. For me, it is all that Dubai, Etihad. Give another example which I am comfortable with.
No, sir. I am just trying to say that Emirates is Dubai-based airline, right?
Okay.
Sir, I went India to US in Emirates.
Yeah, that I'll tell. Okay. I did not come to sixth freedom. No? Exactly. That is the sixth freedom. Correct. The right to fly from a foreign country while stopping in one's own country for non-technical reasons.
Okay.
Understood. So did you stop in Dubai?
Yes.
Correct. Understood. That is sixth freedom. Am I clear? So read this. It will take some time to sink in. Okay. So you think of a scenario where one aircraft, like I said, how I remembered is like one day if I establish airlines, what will I do? Okay. So one by one, it always comes into my mind. So I'll leave this part to your imagination. Okay. Read this line by line. You will understand it. Simple English. Okay. And I have given some extra this thing also so that you will not commit any mistake. Okay. I mean, the only thing you have to remember is you can never conduct domestic air services on a foreign soil unless permitted. I mean, nobody will permit you also.
Don't.
Yeah. Next. Here, every airline will have something called as Air Operator Certificate or Permit. AOC. AOC. Air Operators Certificate. Am I clear? Correct. Now see. This certificate every operator should have to be able to conduct public transport. Correct. Now see. For example, let's take Modi wants to fly to North Korea. Okay. Now, they said here we will not allow any military jets to land, military aircraft to land. Okay. Now, this safety is very important, correct? So, these Air Force guys approached Air India and said, Air India, here, see, we want to take our president, our prime minister to North Korea. So, help us. Okay. Then they ask here, what do you want? You want the only the aircraft, na? They said, no, here. See, we are trying to fly fighter jets. We are taking your Boeing 747. We are not trying to do that. Okay. So Air India says, here Air India gives the aircraft along with crew, the pilots and the cabin crew. Correct. Now, if something happens to this aircraft, it is whose responsibility? Is it the responsibility of Air India or is it the responsibility of the Air Force guys?
Sir, Air Force only.
No. Sir, if it lands in North Korea and if it is damaged there, it will be North Korea's pay.
No.
Okay.
See, if your crew is flying the aircraft, you will be responsible for it. Okay. So, whose crew is flying this aircraft? Air India, correct? So, Air India will be responsibility for the safety of this pilot, not the Air Force. Okay. This kind of lease is called as wet lease. Clear? Correct. So this is called as wet lease. Understood? So if this crew is from Air India, even though it is doing the work for Air Force, but still, who is the operator of this aircraft? Who is the operator in a wet lease? It is Air India. Who is giving the aircraft? That is lessor. I will write Air India here. You understand? Okay, so in this case, Air India is called as LESSOR. That means it is operating under the AOC, Aircraft Operator Certificate of Lesser. Correct. Next. No, here. See. There are two words. Like this English is a bit confusing. Okay, I will write it clearly. One is LESSEE, the company leasing the airplane. Okay, let's see. In this case, that is Air India. No, no. In this case, this is the Air Force, na? Air Force guys are taking. Let's see. They are taking the aircraft, Air Force. Now, the other word is lesser. Means who is giving the aircraft? That is Air India. Clear. So, in a wet lease, who is the operator of the aircraft? Is it the lesser or lessee? Wet lease, the crew also came, correct? So, whoever gave, in this case, the answer would be lesser. Here, my English, not 100%. 75% to 80%. Okay, understand. Fine. Is this clear? What is lessee?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If the Air Force guys say, no, we have pilots trying to fly every aircraft, we just want the aircraft. Okay. That kind of lease is called as dry lease. Clear? That kind of lease is called as dry lease. Now, in a dry lease, who is the operator of the aircraft?
Lessee.
Yeah. Who is the operator in dry lease? Lessee. Am I clear?
Mm.
Okay. Mandan, everything clear?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Here. And you know what is a cabotage? Cabotage is nothing but limitation of domestic air services to the carriers of the same nation.
Sure, we learn too much today.
Here, from this chapter, na? From first chapter, people think, yeah, we will just see before exam, but three questions will come. One from Annexes, one from definitely from this Tokyo to Kyushu, what's the passengers ticketing, correct? This shit got real, Montreal, damage of navigation facilities, all this. Okay. And like, are you comfortable with the class?
Yes, sir.
So I'll take classes on alternate days and every class will be like this. Here, before even you go out of the class, you should memorize everything. Correct. Here, one more thing. See, I want to upload one or two recorded sessions of our classes. When it comes to regulations, you don't mind, correct? Understood. I'll be uploading on my channel only. Fine, here. See you day after tomorrow. Tomorrow, navigation here. Come prepared with, okay, the homework. Manthan, ILS and...
Yes, sir.
Radars.
Sir, I did NDB and viewer.
Also?
Yes. ILS left. I will do by night or tomorrow morning.
Here, Manthan, do you think, here, if there is a exam which is very complex, okay, only complex questions are asked on NDB and VOR, do you think putting all the concepts which you have taught in class, can you cover everything?
Yes, sir.
Everything is understood? It's like a piece of cake now, NDB and VOR sums, correct?
Yes, yes.
By the time we complete radio navigation, I'll conduct another grand test for general lab and radio together. Here, you scored 90, how much?
93 something.
92, 93. So next grand test, I expect you to go over 95. Okay.
Good.
This time also, I want the highest to be from my academy. Okay. And Ramakant, I'm very happy with your marks last time.
Thank you, sir.
I never said it. Okay, bye. See you tomorrow. Take care. Bye, Ramakant.
Bye, sir. Good night. Take care.